you in sort of proposing the single figure, Francis, is really to take a look at how we can sort of simplify the process. Executive comp is fairly sort of complicated. You just need to look at a remuneration report. And there's a, sort of a lot of technical terminology in the report, a lot of fairly complicated types of schemes, which are quite difficult to describe. And our view is, you know, if you're able to sort of benchmark using a single figure or defining a single rate of pay, we just feel that perhaps the communication to the public, communication to shareholders, you know, can just be simplified.
So how does it work? What is the single metric? So it's ranges of pay, yeah. Basically.
So sort of typically what we are looking at is we've sort of run this process for 2 years now. And I think the sort of one conclusion that we came to was benchmarking of executive pay is incredibly difficult. You know, sort of there has been sort of a long-held belief that, you know, as the size of the organization increases, you know, so should the sort of level of pay. And what we found was we really battled to find any correlation between size of organization and pay. So there is a risk that when one benchmarks pay, you just pick a favorable comparator group and you can force the numbers to look any way you want them. What we're sort of proposing with that sort of single figure metric is to say, you know, let's look at the size and scope of the executive role. Let's look at the size of the organization that they oversee. And let's sort of start to propose a potential range that the remuneration committee could consider. Mm. Now, we're not saying that this number needs to be cast in stone. We're sort of simply saying, here's a line in the sand, and you know, we can sort of open the debate from that line in the sand.
Okay, so you have similar sized companies, and then you can say, okay, that executive in that one is earning much more than that one. But what about companies that keep the pay low, but then we see these massive bonuses, and it all seems to be kind of extra salary payments?
And I think that's what we're sort of trying to solve with this whole sort of single figure metric, is almost for the remuneration committee to say, look, we're targeting, let's say, 100, and sort of depending on the life cycle of our organization, where we are in our growth stage, we can then decide how we disseminate that 100. You know, is it going to be a large salary and a small bonus and no shares, or a very small salary and a very big bonus? And, you know, once again, it needs to be horses for courses. Mm. But what we do is let's define the top, and then once we've defined the top, you know, allow the committee to decide how we disseminate that to the individual.
So your research is interesting. You've looked at over 100 companies now, I think in over 7 years. Has exec pay gone up or down? Are people earning too much? What is the actual situation?
So this year we actually included an additional 150 companies in our sample. So we sort of looked at the JSE top 100, and then looked at the next 150 listed companies on the JSE. So I think the sort of headline is, yes, executive pay is increasing, but we're starting to see that the rate at which is increasing is certainly starting to slow down. So we're sort of seeing inflation or below inflation increases this year, and sort of as a 3-year sort of compound annual growth, we're sort of seeing about a 4% increase in pay at the median.
And the thing that causes real resentment is sort of the gap between low-level workers and those execs. Are you monitoring that gap?
We do look at it on a sort of case-by-case basis. You know, as sort of this report, we sort of wanted to focus on executive comp. So we didn't spend too much time looking at pay ratios. And I think the issue with pay ratios are they are sort of fairly complicated and they are company specific. So to sort of try and come up with a standard is very, very difficult. Mm. You know, if you look at a large listed JSE top 10 company with an international footprint, you know, versus a company in the second tier 250, you know, pay at the top is going to be substantially different. pay at the bottom may be similar, the ratios are going to be vastly, vastly different.
Very quickly, are we getting to the point where, say, you as a director can advise companies and say, your execs are earning too much, they're ripping off shareholders? We now have some sort of way of measuring that.
Yeah, I mean, certainly what we would sort of advise our clients is, you know, what we sort of think would be acceptable ranges. You know, once again, it is up to the remuneration committee to make the final call. But certainly, as a firm, you know, we take a sort of pro-business view. You know, we certainly don't want excess. We certainly are anti-excess.
You don't want that, indeed. Now, as we take a look.